comedian, she has a shopping addiction with her husband's credit card. Put your hands together for Just Oliver.
Okay, so who let the 13-year-old on stage? Just kidding, y'all, I'm 15. No, I'm actually almost 30 years old, believe it or not. And yes, I still get carded for things like NyQuil, R-rated movies, getting into the Red Door. Just last few months ago, I was volunteering at Houston Tech High School, and as I was leaving, they tried to give me detention. And my favorite thing is when people mistake my husband for my father. Oh. Hey, Daddy. We save a lot of money with me looking young. You know, we get discounts on movies, at museums, restaurants. You know, I eat free on Tuesdays at Chili's. They do question when you order a kid's meal with a beer, but, you know. So I recently just had a double lung transplant 8 months ago. This was due to my cystic fibrosis, which is a, just Google it. So when I was in the hospital, I got really used to the doctors coming in and asking to see my incisions. I have some pretty wicked scars on my chest now. And I got to the point where anyone would come in the room, I would just flash them, you know, like doctors, nurses, the janitor. But now, I use these scars for like a bunch of stuff. You know, I go to the movies and I'm like, you want tickets? Because, hey! You know, go to McDonald's, flash them, supersize those fries. Chick-fil-A didn't seem to like that, but you win some, you lose some. Awkward. 2 months ago, I went to the dentist, and he started asking me about my transplant, and out of habit, I just sort of flashed him. You know, good thing about that, though, is I walked out of there with a $1,000 crown, courtesy of the dentist himself. I mean, come on. So here's my quick PSA. If you're not an organ donor, make sure you register. I've had that little heart on my license since before I can remember, since transplant was even mentioned to me. Because honestly, I wouldn't want a piece of this. Transplant's not easy, and you know, the side effects from the pills I take alone are crazy. For one thing, hair. I have hair growing everywhere. It's on my face, my back, my neck, my ass. Places you didn't think hair could grow, it grows. Like, did you know elbow hair was a thing? It is. So, my Costco list now always includes things like razors, shaving cream, hedge clippers. My husband really loves the new Harry Me, though. My new nickname is Chewbacca. Also, another side effect of this transplant, the weight gain. So, granted, I was down to 83 pounds, so I needed to gain some weight. But 47 pounds in 8 months was way more than I bargained for. But since I got new lungs, I figured, hey, I'll exercise some. You know, because I really love to eat now. You know, one of my friends the other day told me to eat a bag of dicks. In 5 seconds, I have really great friends. I was like, are they gummy bear dicks or what are they? So like I said, I was like, I'll start exercising. You know, let's get started. Now, I've never exercised a day in my life, so I'll be a runner. Like, that's easy. So I bought new shoes, I bought a new outfit, I bought some chafing cream because my thighs touch now. And I started running. So about 6 minutes into my run, I end up in urgent care with a stress fracture, and I'm in a boot for 6 weeks. So I'm no longer a runner. If anyone has any suggestions, me and these lovely chins of mine would love to hear them. Oh, and nothing really has to be too coordinated, because clumsiness and hypochondria are run in the family. Hypochondria, you know what that means? Google it. Yeah, so I think the worst case of hypochondria in my family would have to be Thanksgiving 2016. I'm looking at you, Daddy. So your family might have Black Friday. My family has Blackout Wednesday. So we go out binge drinking the night before Thanksgiving, and Mom and I are cooking turkey the next day, and we hear Dad. He is on the struggle bus. You hear him moaning and groaning. We've all been there. So Mom, being the sympathetic wife that she is, not at all, decides she'll go check on him. The man legit thinks he is dying. Like, he thinks he's having a heart attack. Mom jokingly says, like, hey, should we call 911? Definitely call 911. I am dying. So after a few WTFs across the room, we decided, we might want to call 911, because if he actually died, we might feel bad. So the EMT guys come in, and we offer them some turkey, you know, ask to see if they want some stuff to take home, and they eventually get back to their job and wheel them off. Doctor calls not too long later, diagnosed him with a hangover. You guessed it. Worst part of all this nonsense, he forgot his cell phone, so he couldn't Uber home. We had to miss half the Panther game to go pick his ass up. I know. And if you ever want to know how much a hangover costs, feel free to ask him after the show, or you could just Google it. Thank you, that's my time. Go over it.
Y'all, I'm gonna tell y'all what. When she came to the class and was like, who don't want a piece of this? I didn't stand up because Janine was in the back, you know, on the phone, but I was like, all right, whatever. Plus, Auburn, her husband was here too, so.